policy as a good example. And why did we select that policy? Because you know that the evidence behind that policy and the effectiveness of that policy is very strong. We know that it is very effective in terms of decreasing mortality, decreasing human suffering, and decreasing cost. And here in our project, we selected this topic also because we know that there is lots of variation how people take care of their hands in caring for others. The model consists of observing the length of hand disinfection in 5 moments. Those are the criteria given by our WHO. And in addition, we observe also whether there is washes or creams or the appropriate measures in care. And before we can rate the patient outcomes, we have to be sure that the professional behave according to guidelines. And this is the case where we are now. The background in this presentation relates to that evidence utilization is a key point in evidence-based practices. We do not need evidence if we do not need it. And if we want to get some patient outcomes. And observation is a very common way or method to collect data or access evidence utilization in practice. And we almost all, I think, we know that, for example, CCEJBI cases program is based mostly on observation. We know that observation is valued as a current standard to reveal what is happening in practice. So it's a more credible way to find out what is actually the process is like, instead of asking people what they think they are doing or what they want to do. But when we observe this, we can see what the concrete practice is. We know that there are detailed methodological considerations available in method books. For example, the role of the observers and type of observation or getting into the field and such kind of issues. But however, we were unable to find information what this is like to observe. And in this case, we were very interested to know what is it like to be observed by those people who are non-researchers, as nurses who are going to observe their bodies. And we need this kind of information in order to facilitate those observers, because our model based on observation. So we have to find issues how to facilitate their own observation. Maybe they might need training or some other. Then we have to develop the intervention which is based on observation. Maybe if those people who observe, if they say that they can make this one for reason or other, so we have to think what is the reason for that. And in order to develop the observation as a method itself. So that's why we need this knowledge about your experience. The study objective was to describe those observers' experiences, and the context was the model in the hospital in Finland. The study participants consisted of 25 background observers who were trained to observe their bodies. And we formed here 5 focus groups for interview, and then we analyzed the content, interview content analysis, the results. In this study, we found also then a concrete issue related to informing staff about observation and support people by the managers. The second group of these results related to their own attitudes towards observation. And they described us that, and some of them were very neutral, it's okay, I have to observe my colleagues. But we found lots of fear and lots of stress relating to go into the chair and their own unit and observe with observation for their colleagues. And they said that there was feelings about disturbing their colleagues. So they, some of them felt very fear when they went there. The third group of the results related their description related to colleagues' attitudes to observation. And this was very nice finding because we were not able to train them to meet those reactions, what they were on the field. The reactions varied from neutral and positive, encouraging reactions. Some professors said that, yes, that's okay that you are observing. This is a very good issue, and this might be a very important issue because the time is allocated for observation. But there is also few very restrictive and even very angry reactions. Then the colleagues were saying that, no, you are not coming to watch me, or something like that. But we found that there is only a few of those. But the observers who got these reactions, they seem to be very frightened before they can get over. And the last group of the results related to the observers' experiences about the method with the observer, their colleagues there, and they say this is very beneficial method. And they feel that they felt so. And it's related that when you are observing, just observing, doing nothing else, but just looking what is happening there, they said, you can see. I couldn't imagine how much I can see when I'm just looking what are they doing. And even very small nuances was noticed there. And then another one related to that they could see very rapidly changes in some kind of issue what they are observing. Also, there are this kind of, and they describe, and they are a little bit concerned about those unreliability issues relating to the method. They were concerned about, of course, there were every unit, patient unit, there are one or two nurses observing their colleagues, and maybe we are observing similar way and calling similar way. They were a little bit scared about this one. And also their concern related to, is that reliable the method, because people will change their behavior when they are observing. And this is also related to their about the method. So I think this will help us when we are going further, and we think that the conclusion I'm not going to, this is a short time to discuss with you, so I'm not giving you very detailed results, but we are reporting this very deeply. So as a conclusion, we found that the observers need support. And we have noticed this later, and they need support from their managers, support from their peer observers, support from their colleagues. And the support needed would be very beneficial. known that since from the 1850, from the Australia, you know, the decision after several points found that hand hygiene is the effective way to decrease maternal mortality. And since those times, the evidence relating to effectiveness of hand hygiene is cumulative. Almost 200 years, it is cumulative evidence that yes, hand hygiene is very good method to prevent mortality and morbidity and so on. And so, even though this huge amount of cumulative evidence, we still discuss about appropriate hand hygiene. We are still discussing should one follow the evidence or not? And I have to express here, this is not Finnish case. This is a case all around the world. So you must not think that Finland is a very poor country. In this case, we are just like the other countries all over the world if you look international. Yeah. And it's very unclear yet why those people who should know or who know why and how to prevent hospital-related infection, they do not follow the guidelines. We have to say some people follow very nicely, but there are some people who think this is not my issue, I can work individual way, this suits me. And this is a big ethical question in care context all over the world, I think so. And the third conclusion related to improving evidence-based practice by continuous monitoring seems to be a very effective method. And I base this conclusion on our experiences, our preliminary results based on 20,000 observation shows that a method is effectiveness in terms of length of increasing length of hand disinfection, increasing use of hand disinfectant, and decreasing amount of catheter-related infection. And these are seen, the trends are seen, we have used this one almost 3 years. And we are now seeing the results. So that's why we think, okay, this observation may be effective. We will see later when it continues this follow-up. And observing people's actual performance, although it is time and human resource consuming method. So however, we have to put to the other bucket that the resource allocated to